So, first time I have all the 38 registrators on board. Everything repeats 38 times. There is just something about repetition that gets the human eye interested, I think. And I can adjust the spring tension by just pulling this out and adjusting this. The nut slides into a groove and can't rotate once the spring puts tension on it. So this spring is really loose now. I pull out the threaded rod, I turn the nut clockwise, and I have perfect control of the spring tension. Down here, you see the programming pins. Here, they will activate these registrators. And as you can see, these things, that's the continuing link of the mechanical movement that will play the music on the Marble Machine X. And these links over to the marble divider. The spring tension system is completely done, and we can turn our attention to the next link in the chain, the marble divider. Welcome to Wintergatan Wednesdays. Problem with the marble divider, long story short. You just saw me making these pieces. They connect to this piece, like this. That connects to the gray pieces that have all different depths. The depth is individual on all 38 channels to accommodate, so every channel has the marbles flush with the surface. To be able to print these and know how deep I want them, I need to be able to know how far the marbles stick up on each channel. And, problem, this width is too wide. I made this too wide in the design, so there's too much room for the marbles, and as you can see, they are placed very randomly. So this height is like changing all the time. So we need to make all the channels inside the marble divider tighter. And what's even worse, I used this bending jig to bend the acrylic, but I bended both the outside piece of the acrylic and the inside piece of the acrylic on the outside curve, which was of course stupid. The inside should have been bent on the inside curve. So the radius of this sheet was wrong, which means that in the middle here, the radius is not really pushing into, keeping the marbles at bay. So I need to make a new acrylic sheet. Got a 4mm sheet instead of the 2mm sheet. Today is the day when we're gonna fix this so we can move on with the build and see the programming wheel drop some marbles. Let's do it. When you heat the material, its atoms start to fly around more wildly and the material expands. And when I heat the top side of the top side expands more than the underside that is colder, so the whole sheet wants to bend down. And you can see that when I put the heat gun under the acrylic and heat the other side of the acrylic wants to stand up again. They use this principle in electric thermostats sometimes by using bimetals. So you have two different kinds of metals that will expand and contract different on different temperatures. So if you have an electric radiator with a thermostat at home, probably could be a bimetal thing in there. So I was struggling to keep the whole acrylic sheet evenly heated with this heat gun. Either it was my patience that was lacking or the power of the heat gun. So I realized that
all the unevenness in the bands comes from different parts of the sheet being colder than other parts. So here I'm trying to correct those uneven mistakes, but it does feel like your best chance is that first band. It's difficult to correct mistakes.
I think this clamp is the most important one in the whole thing. Okay, this looks better. What sound was that? Did I crack something? This thing almost made me give up, but I have a trick up my sleeve. The power of the French sun. I'm gonna fry that acrylic in the French sun and it's going to obey.
Okay.
French sun and a Wintergatan heat gun. Obey.
That crack is gonna haunt my nightmares. So here I'm trying to bend the backside acrylic sheet, and this was the one that failed on the last marble divider. I really need to get this sheet all the way into that curve to really contain the marbles correctly.
Maybe I could save this piece. It's just so warm. So in a way I feel like making a better jig.
So what annoys me with my current method is that I have no relationship to us where exactly where this bend is to where I'm gonna cut the piece. So I wanted to try to solve that problem by designing a new jig that I could bend the acrylic over, and this time also represents the outside contours. So over this jig I will be able to bend both acrylic sheets, both front and back, but then also using the lines from the jig to know exactly where to cut the pieces in relationship to the bend. So I set up the CNC machine, I made all the cut, and I glued up the jig. And it's Wednesday when I'm doing this, and here we go. The outside plate is going to be cut along the outside perimeter of the whole piece, and the inside plate, that is against this curve, is going to be cut at this line and at this line. So this is actually the first time I have a perfect way to clamp this. I can now trace the outline of exactly where I need to cut this piece. At this point I started to feel hopeful again because the front side sheet looked nice, so I started to bend the backside sheet. So this video just got a different ending. I cracked the whole piece. I was not patient enough when I was clamping, and I think my heat gun is actually not powerful enough to properly melt this 4mm acrylic over this whole surface. I don't have another sheet and I don't have time to go and get one, so it's such a big mess. look at this mess. Oh, it's such a big mess. Well, it's not engineer like at all. Should we do some disc golf trick shot or something? I'm not at all happy with myself. I'm really, really not happy with how this went. I had to walk away from this chainsaw symphony, and also I had to walk away from my failed project to finish this video.
I was thinking why I failed with this. When I built the first machine, one of my biggest regrets was that I only made videos when things went well. And then when I started on this marble machine, I was like thinking, this time I'm gonna allow myself to show when things go bad. And so far I always want to finish every video with some kind of payoff, like some kind of completion. I'm constantly thinking about why it takes so long time, my project. And I think it's because I do stuff over and over again and I redo them instead of like making sure that I got it right the first time. So the art is not to never fall, but to rise after each fall. Which is true, but for me now, I've already mastered the rise after falling part. I'm actually a master at rising after a fall, and I'm maybe too good at it because I don't mind failing, but I think I should be like this football diva who just hates to lose a little bit more now. I also remember when Marius broke a drill bit, he was angry for 3 days afterwards, and I was like, oh, no problem, and he was like, no, but I shouldn't have made that mistake. And I think maybe I want to learn to be a little bit more like that. Changing habits is really difficult, right? So I should change my habit of allowing myself to make this many mistakes, because it's really what's happening. Right after uploading this video, I'm gonna put myself in the car, go and get some more acrylic sheets, and then go back to the drawing board and rise from this fall. I think I should really learn now to work with more intent. It's like, think more like an engineer. If you had a work as an engineer, you could not fool around like I am doing. It's like, just because I'm by myself and I'm my own boss, I'm like allowing myself to fool around this much. So I'm going to end this video here in the flowers. Slower tempo will increase the overall tempo. As long as we learn. No?
I did succeed with a demagnetizer and I posted that video 2 days ago on the Monday, so check that out if you want to see some progress.
It's 35 degrees here now, and normally that's not so bad, but it's a lot of moist in the ground, so there's high air humidity. So 35 degrees with high air humidity is quite a lot for a weak Swede.